Cancel culture is a conservative and right-wing concept that is used to fend off emancipative politics, especially regarding sexism, racism, homophobia, and transphobia. The critique of cancel culture is quite clever. It presents the demand to end discrimination as a rigid leftist moralism that destroys freedom of speech, artistic freedom, and academic freedom, and thereby also the democratic pluralistic discourse. And thus, cancel culture turns emancipative politics into a restriction of freedom for everybody. The desire of conservatives to defend their own privileges thus appears as something different, nicer, broader, the defense of universal rights, and not just their own interest at the expense of minorities. The cancel culture discourse has been quite successful with this universalization strategy. Concern about cancel culture nowadays cuts across political camps and is often not even associated with conservative politics. However, in most cases in which cancel culture is mentioned, freedom of speech, artistic and academic freedom are not restricted at all. These freedoms are primarily defense rights against the state. They do not mean that there are no norms and rules in public debate, culture, and academia. Rules do exist, of course, and it goes without saying that changing them to make them less discriminatory also means that the currently privileged lose discursive power, airtime, or funding. After all, the current distribution of power is based on structural and brutal exclusions of the perspectives of many minorities. They are effectively cancelled from the outset. The pluralization and democratization of discourses makes it necessary to redistribute resources so that the freedom of the privileged is reduced in order to establish freedom for all. And such changes in norms, rules, and structures are something completely different than restricting freedom of speech, artistic, and academic freedom. However, restrictions of these freedoms do exist, but they aren't usually criticized by the conservative and right-wing discourse on cancel culture. In England and France, the government is currently trying to prevent academic research on anti-racist and post-colonial theories. In Germany, the Bundestag, with its BDS resolution, and following it, the German Rectors' Conference, are powerfully intervening in an ongoing public debate and restricting academic freedom. Because here, the state intervenes with enormous symbolic, financial, and juridical power, freedom rights are actually threatened in these cases. And if you want to hold on to the term, you could say that this is the real cancel culture.